Oh, my word, and suddenly the aircraft sea pressurized. You've got to get these oxygen masks on as quick as you possibly can. Okay, in you go, fast as you can.
So my name's Hugh Montgomery. I'm Professor of Intensive Care Medicine at UCL in London, University College London, where I direct the Institute for Human Health and Performance. And my lectures were in 2007 on the science of survival, with a sort of running title of Back from the Brink.
When a meteorite struck the Earth, it produced massive climate change. And that climate change was not something that the dinosaurs could adapt to. And they died, but your ancestors survived. And in fact, they were lucky. But you're very lucky too, because there have been five or six episodes of mass extinction in the Earth's history, all caused by climate change, and every single time, your ancestors have survived.
In every case, we managed to hang the lecturer around a real-life survivor. So that, for me, was the most exciting part of it. We had sort of tremendous people in, Mike Stroud, who'd manhauled across Antarctica, the man of finds, and from that slot up there, right in the ceiling, abseiling in Jamie Andrew, who'd been stuck on a mountain in the Alps for nearly 7 days and ended up having both arms and legs amputated.
Well, there's an entrance, Jamie. Thank you very much for joining this. Now, this was an extraordinary feat of survival. I think people looking at that mountain might not have quite a feel for how cold it was. How cold were you on that ridge?
It was very cold indeed. I mean, the temperatures were measured at minus 30 degrees C.
And strong winds as well.
130 kilometres an hour down in the valley that day, so...
Yeah. I think the demonstrations are crucial to the Christmas lectures, partly because that's what they've always had in them. It's like trying to have Christmas without turkeys and pudding. You just can't do it as a Christmas lecture. And CGI and so forth will never replace that real sense of awe children get when they see something happening in front of them, which can also go wrong.
And they're working on quite low pressure. And what I'd like you to do, without stabbing and putting your finger through, is give that a push for me when it's inflated. What does it feel like?
Squidgy.
There we go. Isn't that beautiful? And it's a lovely looking heart, that. Put a twist in it. The molecule just twists around. And as you can see, if Andy kept doing that, you get the famous double helix of DNA, which you can see over here.
In terms of things going wrong, I suppose that's also rather a tradition of the Christmas lectures, and actually makes it all the more fun, because they're not edited out, these things that go wrong. When things don't work, that's part of the narrative. And we had a model just over to my right, actually, from where I'm sitting now, of a cut-out man with a column that was meant to give an index of how much water he had in them, and we got a child sort of pouring in water to the level that he'd been at. But of course, as often in the Christmas lectures, we were down to the wire. Andy had been working all night again to try to get things together. Everyone rushed to get out there. Off we go. The child is on the stairs. He's pouring the water in, and it just poured straight out of the bottom all over the floor.
Oh, it's leaking. We better stop, haven't we? He's having a pee. Your dad can't hold his beer, can he? Right. Well, better get you out of the way.
Presenting to children is every bit as demanding as presenting to adults, if not more so. And I was trained by a professor many years ago called Eric Neal, who was one of the world's great physiologists. And I remember him saying to me when I was merely a BSE student, you know, he said to me, Hugh, if you can't explain your science to a five-year-old, it means you don't understand it.
So genes are very important because at the beginning of each of them, there's a little accelerator region. Just imagine it as a few of these letters. And if you switch on that accelerator, you switch on the gene. You switch on the gene, you make more of the protein. So a gene determines which protein you make, in what cell, how much, and when.
So I suppose all in all, the Royal Institution lectures are hugely stressful, very time consuming, but an enormous honour, tremendously good fun, and the reward of hearing 300 children for 5 nights in a row hanging on your every word is fantastic. I'd strongly commend it for others to do in the future.